ओम शांति। इट्स माय प्रिविलेज टू बी विथ यू एंड टॉक अबाउट दोज गुड ओल्ड डेज ड्यूरिंग विच पीरियड यू सी आई हैड वेरी इंटीमेट कनेक्शन विद ब्रह्मा बाबा एंड मातेश्वरी एंड टू एक्सप्रेस एंड ऑल दिस एक्सपीरियंसेस इन डिटेल इट मे टेक मोर देन 10-15 आवर्स ऑल्सो But I would like to be very brief and touch some of the important events only so that you can have glimpses of these experiences with Brahma Baba and Mateshwari ji. Long back in 1950, I lost my father, and because of that my mother was suffering from depression. I tried to remove this depression by taking my mother to various gurus also, various pilgrimage places also, but I could not succeed. But in June 52, I suddenly found that depression condition of my mother, so slowly and slowly, you see, she was coming out of the depression condition and she was behaving in her normal manner. So I tried to notice it. I thought it might be a temporary phase also. But after watching her improvement and behavior for more than 1 month, I asked my mother that how is it this depression is over and you are now behaving like a normal human being. This was in June 52. So my mother said that in May 52, in the early May 52, these Brahma Kumari sisters have come to Bombay, and within first 15 days of these sisters in Bombay, I got connection with them and I started learning Brahma Kumari's yoga and knowledge. And there we are taught that we are not body but we are soul and all those things. You see, we all know all these things about Raj Yoga. So by doing this Raj Yoga, slowly and slowly, I was relieved of my depression. So I told my mother that, yes, it's very good, you see, kindly convey my thanks to Brahma Kumari sisters that they have removed and they have cured my mother's depression sickness. Then in August 52, my mother and my two Laukik sisters, they decided to come to Mount Abu. In fact, these three were the first visitors to Mount Abu after 1950, that means after arrival of Brahma Kumari sisters and Brahma Kumari brothers and all those things, Brahma Baba, in India. And they came to Bombay in May 52. Till that time, nobody, as a student of godly services done by these Brahma Kumari sisters, had visited Mount Abu. And when they came here, Brahma Baba said that these are the first students of India after having transferred their head office from Karachi to Mount Abu. Then I just go further, and then what happened that in 53, Brahma Baba had some kidney trouble was there, so he was brought to Bombay. And when Brahma Baba was in the hospital, my mother told me that, will you like to come to the hospital and inquire about the health of Brahma Baba? I said, yes. So that was the first stepping stone of my building my relationship with Brahma Baba. So when I came to the hospital, I saw Brahma Baba sleeping on the hospital bed. I had seen the statue of Lord Buddha near Bombay, about 200 miles from Bombay. There are Ajanta and Ellora caves. Ellora caves are mostly Buddha caves, you see, or really caves related to Buddha religion. And there was one statue of Lord Buddha. Lord Buddha sleeping on the rocks. It was really a very nice, impressive carving. So when I saw Brahma Baba, my first reaction was that he is just like a prophet and a founder of a religion or founder of a new world order. So I was just amazed, and I was looking at him for about 3-4 minutes. Baba also gave me drashti and all those things. And then I asked Brahma, Baba, that, Baba, how is your health? You are operated. He said, no, I was not operated. So that was a new answer to me. He was operated, but he said, no, I was not operated. So I said, yes, you are operated. He said, no, I was not operated. So I asked my mother, you told me that Brahma Baba was operated, and Brahma Baba says that he is not operated, he was not operated. So my mother also told Brahma Baba, Baba, you are operated. We are daily hear your news in our classes also. So then Baba smiled at me and then said, that child, I was not operated, my body was operated. So that was the first understanding or first distinction between self, that means I the soul, and my body. And then Baba gave me first lesson. You know, all of you must have heard that first lesson as to who am I. Am I right? You all have had this first lesson. So I also got first lesson about Brahma Kumari's knowledge, this divine knowledge from Brahma Baba directly in the hospital, from the hospital bed. So this is my luck, I would say, that you see, to get knowledge from Brahma Baba from the hospital bed in the very first meeting. So that is how, you see, I got this knowledge. And Baba said that, I am giving you this first lesson, then you should go to the center and take further knowledge. So like that, you see, that was the first reaction or first meeting. Then next year in 63, Mateshwari came to Bombay, and I saw for the first time Mateshwari also. I was wonderstruck because Mateshwari was wearing sari, you see, in a Parsi style. So I asked my mother, is she Parsi? You know, Parsi religion is a separate religion. And this sister, you see, wears sari in a different manner, not like Gujarati lady or Bengali lady and all those things. Most of the sisters here, you see, who are wearing saris, they wear it in a Bengali style manner. So my mother said, no, no, she is Sindhi only. Then I said, but why she is wearing sari like this? So my mother told me that she was educated in Bombay in a Parsi school. And because of her education in a Parsi school, you see, she has adopted this style of wearing sari. So we had a long discussion during this first visit also. And then Mateshwari went to Bangalore and other places. There was no other contact. But then in 57, September or October, my mother came to me and said that, mother, Ramesh, I want to invite Brahma Baba and Mateshwari to Bombay. I said, yes, we can invite. So my mother told me that, do you know the meaning of word invitation? I said, yes, I know it very well. When we are giving invitation to Brahma Baba and Mateshwari, it means that all his expenses, all their expenses from Mount Abu to Bombay, and stay during the stay in Bombay and return back to Abu, that we have to take care. So my mother asked me, can we afford to pay for these expenses? I said, why not? So my mother wrote an invitation letter to Baba, Brahma Baba. And Brahma Baba refused to accept that invitation. So I could not understand why, but Baba had his own yukti, you see, he had a certain aim and object in refusing invitation from my mother. And then at the bottom of his letter, he wrote that if the child, I mean, if Ramesh gives me invitation, then I will like to come and stay in Bombay. So my mother asked me, that we write the invitation. I said, I don't know your language. So we had brother Dada Anand Kishore in Bombay. So yeah, I asked him to draft invitation. In fact, Dada Anand Kishore also told me that, why you are not writing? Because you are a chartered accountant, you are a lawyer, and you can draft easily. I said, but I don't know Brahma Kumari's language. He said, what type of language? So I gave him one example, that you have that word Sikilada. You must have heard that word Sikilada. Long lost and found again, you see, like that. That is the English translation, verbatim translation. So I don't know what is this, all these words in your divine dictionary. So he wrote, and then I signed. And Brahma Baba sent a reply by telegram that, yes, book flat for me for 4 months. And then the real struggle started. We started searching flats for Baba, Brahma Baba. And when we were going to enter into agreement with the owner of a flat, I requested Dadi Pushpasanta that we must book it for 4.5 months. So Dadi Pushpasanta said, nothing doing. Baba has given permission to only book a flat for 4 months only. I said, don't worry, you see, I will take care of this problem, but let us book it for 4.5 months. So that matter went to Brahma Baba also. Brahma Baba said, okay, I will handle Ramesh also. So when he came, I had my car, so I was driving my car. Brahma Baba was sitting next to me. At the back, Mateshwari was sitting, and next to that, Mateshwari was my mother. And the moment I started driving the car, Baba started testing my views on this 4 months or 4.5 months. We had a very tough discussion. Baba said that you are violated my direction. I told you to book it for 4 months. Why you have booked for 4.5 months? And all those things, you see, he just took my examination for more than 20-25 minutes during the time when I was driving the car. Then Baba stopped. Then I told Baba that, have you put up all your questions? He said, yes. Then I said, Baba, can I give you my answers? He said, yes. So I told Brahma Baba, Baba, if you had, as per your direction, if we had booked this flat for 4 months, then we would have got possession of this flat today morning at 6 o'clock only. And your train has arrived in Bombay at 6:25. Within 25 minutes, we could not have made any arrangement for your safe stay in Bombay. Instead of that, we have booked it for 4.5 months. We took possession of the flat 5 days in advance. And during these 5 days in advance, we have painted this flat. So Baba asked me, why you have wasted money on painting the flat? I said, you are such a great personality. And for such a great personality, we must have nice accommodation, nicely newly colored, and all those, this flat also. We have new tarpaulin, new linoleum, new furniture, and all those things. And then sisters have occupied since yesterday. And today, by the time we reach the place where you are going to stay, there will be everything ready. Class will be also ready. Breakfast also will be ready. Everything will be ready. This could not have taken place if we had booked flat for only 4 months. So Baba said, okay, you are good lawyer. You are good, arguing very nicely with me. I said, no, it is not my argument. I am just trying to explain my contention, my decision of 4.5 months. And then at the end, when we reached that place, you see, the name of the building was Western Court. Just at the time when we reached the Western Court, I told Brahma Baba that, Brahma Baba, I have heard your knowledge. I know about Brahma Kumari's knowledge, and I know that Rama is more powerful than even God also. And therefore, I think my decision of booking it for 4.5 months will be justified by the Rama. And today you may object, but ultimately you will have to accept my decision. So he was looking at me, and so he was thinking that why this boy is asking like this. So Baba went up, then we had a class also and all those things. For 4.5 months, you see, we had daily in the evening, you see, I used to go to the place where Brahma Baba was staying. We used to take Brahma Baba for a walk in the evening, many times also in the morning also. There was one garden, Hanging Garden, and Kamala Nehru Park. There were two gardens. In this Kamala Nehru Park, there was one long cement concrete boot. And so Brahma Baba said, okay, Ramesh, come on, let us climb this boot. this cement concrete book. We went up in this, and then we were saying, looking at the garden. And then on that day, during the Murli class, Baba said that this Brahma Baba is the long boot of Shiva Baba. And Shiva Baba is coming in this body, occupying this long boot. Like that, he gave that Murli about long boot. So this is how you see Baba was also taking examples of the worldly things and giving explanation and everything. I asked once also Brahma Baba that my friends and relatives say that, you see, Brahma Baba thinks that God is coming in his body, because many rich people think like that. And is it just a fact that because you are rich, you have publicized to everybody that God is coming in your body? So Baba looked at me for 1 minute and said that, no child, I am not making any wrong propaganda. It's a fact that Sri Baba has taken on loan, on rent, my this body. And he is coming and he is giving his knowledge. Like that, we had many discussions, questions and answers. I asked Brahma Baba also, with what amount you started this institution and all those things. And being chartered accountant, Baba had faith in me and gave all the examples, all the amounts because of which he started the institution. I can give you one example, that when he separated from his partner, you know, formerly Brahma Baba was working in a jeweler's shop in Calcutta. But then Brahma Baba and the accountant of his boss, and they joined into and made a new partnership, started new business. And then for such a long period, you see, Brahma Baba was acting as a senior partner, and they made money, you see, minted money, so to say. But then Brahma Baba had this divine insight, Divya Drashti, as we call it, you see, Sakshatkar. And then Baba decided to quit. So he wrote a letter to his partner that I want to resign from this partnership. Let us divide whatever we have got in our partnership business. So his partner wrote to Brahma Baba that, yes, let us sit together. Baba said that, I don't want to come there. You decide, I have got full faith in you. And then his partner said that, I was accountant only. I don't know anything about this diamond business and this jewelry and all those things. So I will take the cash from you, from the partnership firm, and you take the stock of all the diamonds and all other jewelry. Baba said, nothing doing. Okay, whatever you decide, whatever you want to take and whatever you want to give to me, you give to me. And then Baba separated from his partner. Baba got all the diamonds, and that partner got all the cash and bank and all bank balances and all those things. Look, the importance of this division of assets between his partner and Brahma Baba, that slowly and slowly, market prices of diamonds went up. Baba used to send Vishwakishore Dada to Calcutta and sell the diamond stock slowly and slowly. With the result, when the prices went up, there was the Second World War also, and all those things were there. Therefore, whatever funds that he received on partition from his partner, he accumulated and made big, huge profit. So this division also worked in favor of Brahma Baba. And therefore, Brahma Baba said that, look, drama, as per drama, he made profits. In fact, because of that division and because of those diamonds and all those things, the institution worked right from 1937 right up to 1950 or 51. Now that means, you see, profit of what Brahma Baba earned during his business life, you see, that enabled the institution to work right from 1937 to 1950 or so. And then slowly, Brahma Baba decided to send sisters and brothers right to other places in India also for godly service and all those things. You must be knowing that famous example Dadi Janki is always giving, that when Dadi Janki was told by Brahma Baba that you go on service And then Radhi Janaki said, nothing doing, I am not going to leave you. I will stay with you only here in Pandav Bhavan. And then Brahma Baba very nicely put that question to Radhi Janaki, that okay, you can stay here, but from where I will have second Janaki? From where I will have second Janaki? And then Dadi said, yes, you will not get second Janaki. Then the Baba said that if I will not get second Janaki, then you will have to go for godly service. Like that, slowly and slowly, Brahma Baba gave farewell to all the sisters. Some of the sisters went to Delhi, some of the sisters came to Ahmedabad, and from Ahmedabad to Bombay and all those things. And a third batch went to Bangalore also. And in Bombay, within 15 days, you see, my mother, and through my mother, I came into contact with Brahma Baba. So for 4 months, we were together. Daily in the evening, most of the time, we used to take dinner with Brahma Baba and all those things, you see, nice chit-chat and all those things, and the evening class will be also there. And then, at the end of the 4th month, Baba said that, yes, tomorrow is the last day of my stay of 4 months. You go and book my tickets. I said, okay. I never registered Brahma Baba, but I knew that in the drama there will be something which we cannot predict. So the tickets were booked, and on Saturday, just one day for on Monday evening he was to go to Abu. On Saturday, Dada Vishwakishore had taken appointment of Dada Brahma Baba of a local doctor, local senior doctor, because at that time there was not so good medical facility in Abu, and therefore I was driving the car, I and Brahma Baba, my local sister who is a doctor, and Brahma Baba, which four of us went to a doctor. Doctor examined him and all those things. Then he said, he prescribed that do this particular blood test and then come back again with the patient, again with Brahma Baba, and then I will prescribe medicine. So that was on Saturday late in the evening. So nothing could be done. Next day was Sunday. So all labs in Bombay were closed on that day. So on Sunday, in any case, my sister came to Brahma Baba, took blood from the left hand of Brahma Baba and kept it in fridge. And then on Monday morning, we went to a nearby lab and gave that blood bottle to Brahma, to that lab in charge. He said, he accepted the blood and then said that, come after 3 days. The blood report will be ready after 3 days. And then Dada Vishwa thought, what is this? Brahma Baba has to leave today. And the doctor says that you get this report ready and then come to me with the patient. Now, how this is possible? So Dada told me, Ramesh, what to do? I said, let us go to Brahma Baba and ask him what he wants to do. He wants to go to Abu, irrespective of this medical test and irrespective of doctor's certificate and all those things. Let him go. What can we do? Because after all, he is our spiritual father. So we went to Brahma Baba. And then I knew what will happen. So I stood far away. And then Dada Vishwakishore went to Brahma Baba and said that, Baba, this blood test report will come only on Thursday morning. It cannot come before Thursday morning. So either you have to cancel your trip to Abu, or you go to Abu and then we will collect the report, and then we don't know what will happen. So Baba thought for a minute, and then he started looking at me like that. And then he said that, now the child has won and I have lost the battle. So he called me, Ramesh, come. I went there. Baba said that, look, child, you told me that drama is more powerful than me. And it is now a fact that I will have to extend my stay in Bombay. I will be staying beyond 4 months. So I said, Baba, that is what I told you, you see. And therefore, only I had booked this flat for 4.5 months. You can stay here for further 10 days also. Today is the last day. Further 10 days you can stay. So he said, no, I will get report on Thursday morning. I will go to the doctor on Thursday evening. And I will go back to Bombay. I'm to Abu. I said, why, Brahma Baba, why you are in a hurry? to go to Abu. In between, there will be holidays on Saturday and Sunday. And let all the sisters and brothers of Bombay come to you, listen to your Murli, because on Saturday and Sunday they are more free and they can mix with you, and they have the benefit of all this divine atmosphere and facilities and all those things. So you go to Abu on next Monday. So he said, how many days are still left? I said, I had already taken for 5 days, and then if you stay, extend your stay for 7 days, in all 12 days, even then you will get 3 days. So Baba said, okay, you win and I lose. I said, Baba, it's not a question of who is winning and who is losing. It is a question of your health. And as for your health, it is our duty to take paramount action about the safety of your health. And Mateshwari was also there, you see. She was also talking. She also said, yes, Baba, let us extend our stay in Bombay. And therefore, what happened that, you see, Baba stayed for 7 days, that means further 7 days. And that is how, you see, we had always that discussion in between. And daily in the evening also, when we used to go out, I used to ask so many questions to Baba. Because I discussed with Brahma, Baba said that, Baba, as per our scriptures, it is said that God can do anything and everything, and he can do nothing also. Kartum akartum anyatha kartum, that is in the Sanskrit. So I said, your God is bound by drama, and my God is free. He can do anything, absolutely free. So my God is more powerful than your God. And then Baba told me that, Ramesh, I wish there had been such a God who can do anything and everything, and who is not bound by drama. But there is no such God. All the God that we know, and God who is teaching through me, he is bound by drama, he is bound by so many things also. So like that, we had so many discussions and very clear understanding of Baba's knowledge. But I did not accept Brahma Baba as my spiritual father. I accepted Brahma Baba as my mother's guru, spiritual guru. And in that manner, I used to discuss and meet Brahma Baba during the morning class, during the evening class, during our morning walk or evening walk, or also during our dinner late in the evening. So like that, you see, for 4.5 months, Brahma Baba was there. And then we used to have so many discussions and letters and all those things, you see. Then what happened that in 1960, I got married to Usha. And Usha had a very peculiar understanding about Brahma Baba. What happened that before joining these Brahma Kumaris, we were students of one Gita Pathshala. And there we were taught this yoga as taught by Patanjal. So this Patanjal yoga was there, and we were following the Patanjal yoga. And therefore, we used to get up early in the morning at 4 o'clock. She was staying in her maternal uncle's house and all those things. And I was staying in my residence. We were not having any connection, but we were doing this morning yoga. So when we started doing morning yoga, what happened? She was sleeping separately in the kitchen, so that if she will not disturb all her other relatives. And she had a very nice picture of Sri Krishna, and she was doing yoga with Sri Krishna. And then what happened? That after 4 or 5 days, you see, she saw one image in the window, passage window. And from that window, that person, you see, was throwing battery torch light on the picture of Krishna. And picture of Krishna used to vanish. And instead of that, picture of somebody else will come. So she thought that this thief is there, and this thief has come here to do this stealing work and all those things. So in the beginning, for the first day, she was afraid of this thief. So she took the blanket on her head and she slept. Again, second day, same thing happened. So again, she was worried and she was sleeping. Then on the third day, when that thief came, then she said, what is this? This thief is coming and only throwing torch light on the picture of Krishna. He is not stealing, he is not doing anything else. And afterwards, he goes away. What is this? There is something else. He must not be a thief. And then, you see, I wrote letter to our guru, you see, who was teaching us this Patanjali Yoga. And then he replied that, you come to on Sunday morning class, and I will show you that the type of description that you have given, there are two boys in our institution. I will ask you to identify whose picture is coming in front of you after that thief's torchlight is on that Krishna picture. So next Sunday, I used to visit that institution only on Sunday morning. So when I visited that the spiritual guru, you see, was teaching us Patanjali Yoga. When I went inside, Usha was sitting next to our that guru. And then our guru asked, is this the same person? She said, yes, this is the same person whose picture is being thrown into, whose picture is coming in front of me on account of the torch light of that thief. So he said that, okay, let me try to understand these things. He asked Usha to come next day. And then he said that, it means that there is a godly suggestion that you must marry this person. Usha said, if I don't marry, then what will happen? Then you see, said, you will not get the real benefit of your life. So you decide these things. And he said that, yes, I will take care of these things. And then see that marriage takes place. So my mother and her mother and others, you see, they decided that we got married. And we got married on Sunday. And on Monday morning, my mother took me and Usha to Brahma Baba. And then the moment Brahma Baba came out and we were sitting in the hall, the moment Brahma Baba came out, Usha told me that he is the same thief who was coming to me in the morning, you see, and throwing torch light on that Krishna picture, and your picture was coming out. So then he said, this is not thief, he is Brahma Baba, he is the founder of the Brahma Kumaris Institution, he is the medium and body, whose body is being utilized for godly service. And then we had a discussion and all those things. So look at it, that Brahma Baba, you see, in the subtle form, even during his, when he was in the physical form also, in his subtle form, he used to come to Usha's house, Usha, and the place where she was sleeping. And then he was using this torch light, so to say. It was all divine experiences. And then that Usha then realized when he saw for the first time Brahma Baba. And then we realized that there is something very important spiritual power in this institution, and also in Brahma Baba also, that his subtle form is coming to Usha and giving torch light and asking Usha to marry me. And that is how, you see, our marriage also was a divine marriage. I don't think any of you will be having this type of divine marriage where, you see, Brahma Baba will be throwing a torch light on your picture, and your wife might be thinking of who is this and whether he is thief or what. So this is what, somebody asked me, what type of marriage you had? I said that was our divine marriage arranged by Sri Baba. And we had decided from the beginning, right from the beginning, that we will have spiritual life. We will have a pure life also. So that was also conveyed to Baba by my mother and all those things. So like that, you see, we had very good connection with Brahma Baba. And then matter went on and on, went on. And then in 61, we came to Mount Abu. In 61, that was my first trip, Usha's first trip also to Mount Abu. And then we stayed here for about 15 days. But till that time also, I was not accepting Brahma Baba as my spiritual father or alaukik father. But I accepted Brahma Baba as guru of my mother, spiritual guru of my mother. With great esteem, I had great respect for Brahma Baba also. Till the time we were leaving Pandav Bhavan, at that time, Santri Dadi, she was the chief messenger sister during those days. She asked me also, what do you think of Brahma Baba? I said to that Santri Dadi, that spiritual messenger sister, that he is the guru of my mother. And from that angle, I also respect him as my guru, but not as my spiritual father. So Brahma Baba came to know about this reaction. But at that time, you see, he used to come to give us send off. There is a banyan tree at the back of Pandav Bhavan. So he used to come to that place also. And then say, he will wave his handkerchief like this. And till that place, you see, we were talking with Brahma Baba and all others also. And then when we were about to leave, Baba had tears in his eyes. Tears of love, tears of respect, tears, you know, all those things, you see. There are various varieties of tears, tears of pain and misery also, tears of pleasure also, tears of love and all those things. So Brahma Baba had tears in his eyes, and then he took his handkerchief and removed those tears from his eyes. And that was the turning point. And that, you see, those tears, that were, when Brahma Baba became avyakta, I wrote my article in it, that I wrote that, yes, these tears in Brahma Baba's eyes were like arrow. And that arrow, you see, caused a wonderful change in me. And during our return journey, I asked Usha that, look, the greatness of this Brahma Baba, that because on that day in the morning, Baba had given Murli on attachment and all those problems caused by attachment. So I said, look, he has got wonderful understanding of what is attachment and what is pure love. And he has given us pure love. And we have, till the departure time, we have said that he is not our spiritual father. He is the father, he is the Sadguru of my mother. Even then, in spite of that, he gave us so much of love that he had tears of love in his eyes. So we both decided after returning back to Bombay to have morning yoga. We sent message to Sri Baba through messenger sister. And then Baba said that, yes, come to center in the morning at 5 o'clock. So 5 to 6 we had daily this yoga. And during this 7 days time, we had that complete change within us. And we accepted Brahma Baba. So both of us wrote letter to Brahma Baba that we hereby accept you as our spiritual father and Mateshwari as our spiritual mother. So this is how, you see, our connection with Brahma Baba was developed. Baba used to write letters for making purchases and all those things, for all routine work also. The very first Godly Service Act I had done was that Brahma Baba wrote to me that, child, we want buckets, plastic buckets in Pandav Bhavan. So purchase 500 buckets and send them by truck to Abu. That was something new because I was not knowing where the buckets would be available, how it go to Abu and all those things. Anyhow, with the help of my friend, we purchased 500 buckets. And we send it to Abu also, because till that time, every Brahma Kumar or Kumari party coming, every Brahma Kumar will have two things. One bucket containing a tiffin and all those things, and the other one bedding for night journey, you see, in the train, you see. So they had to have this, and also bedding for sleeping, even in Pandav Bhavan also. We are not having sufficient beds for the inmates or visitors also in the Pandav Bhavan. So that was the first purchase. As per direction of Brahma Baba, we purchased 500 buckets and sent to Brahma Baba. Then we sent forms and all those things, and slowly what happened that all these Brahma Kumars and Kumaris coming to Abu, they were required not to bring their buckets and they're also bedding for sleeping at night time in Pandav Bhavan. So this is how Vasu Baba asked us to be what we call as active partner, active brother, active BK in our divine family. And then I had a very nice discussion with Brahma Baba. Baba was not in favor of registering the institution, and Baba was not in favor of buying any property. I am telling you of 1962. Right from 1962 till 1968, I used to write letters to Brahma Baba. Baba, you will have to change your policy. We will have to register an institution which will be acting as a buffer between your principles and the worldly laws. we will have to register the institution. Baba was never in favor of writing, getting institution registered and buying properties. Then suddenly in November 1968, Dadi Prakash Mani was our teacher in Gandhivi Center. So we received a letter from Brahma Baba, that child addressed to me and Dadi Prakash Mani, that you are always insisting on forming a trust, forming an institution to take care of the properties. And I think, you see, you come to Abu and you establish, you draft this trust and gave me details of this trust and all those things. And then I and Dadi Prakash Mani came to Abu, and then immediately Baba said that child, Ramesh, Dada Anand Kishore, Dadi Prakash Mani and Didi Manmohini, we should sit together and discuss the details of the trust. And then we started discussing and all those things. Daily in the evening, Baba will answer all our questions, and then we started drafting the trust. And then the last point about drafting of the trust was, who will become the managing trustee? Didi Manmohini said that, Ramesh, you will have to become managing trustee. I said, nothing doing, I will not become the managing trustee. She said, then we had a long discussion in the meeting. Then we, Dadi Prakash Mani said that, let us leave this problem to Brahma Baba, let him decide. I said, okay, let Brahma Baba decide. And then in the evening, you see, we had this discussion, Brahma Baba and myself, there was discussion. I said, nothing doing, I am not going to become the managing trustee, you will have to become. And Baba, he asked me so many questions, and I answered that, why, you see, I did not become a managing trustee, because I said, there are many other senior sisters and brothers, and they are my seniors. How can I overtake my seniors? If I overtake my seniors, then a day will come when my juniors will overtake me, and at that time I will have pain and misery. And like that, so many questions were there. Ultimately, Baba had that Brahmastra. You know, those who are doing in Indian psychology or Indian philosophy, they know that is in Mahabharata war. Aswatthama had Brahmastra, knowledge of Brahmastra. And Krishna, you see, asked all the Pandavas and all those people that they should throw away their armaments and all those things, you say, weapons and all those things, and stand in silence and bow down before the Brahmastra. Then the Brahmastra will not kill you. Otherwise, if you start fighting with Brahmastra, you will be killed by Brahmastra. So that was the Brahmastra. So then when he said that, Ramesh, you were managing trustee in the past, you will become managing trustee in this kalpa, and then you will be becoming managing trustee in every kalpa in future also. And then he asked me, will you accept this thing? I said, this is now your Brahmastra. Ultimate discussion, ultimate suggestion, and ultimate direction. And I will have to bow down before your Brahmastra. I mean, I will accept this post. But then I told him that, Baba, I don't have any knowledge about this managing institution, managing trust, and all those things, you see. I am a chartered accountant dealing with income tax laws and all these worldly laws. I am not I don't have experience of managing institution like this. Trust means managing the trust also. Then Baba gave a very nice example and very nice guidance. It will be useful to you also. Baba said that, I know you don't have that experience, but if you have any problem of management or finance or anything else, you sit in meditation. Sit in meditation and remember. Don't remember me, but remember that what you had done or what you had decided before 5,000 years. Don't think of 5,000 years, but think of it as a matter of yesterday. And so you have to decide on the strength of your experience of yesterday. You have to decide it today. And you decide it today, and then let me know. Or you start doing work according to your that experience which you had regained through your yoga, based on your past life and past actions and all those things. And that is what I have followed so far. And therefore, what has happened, that in all my decisions, in all my actions and all those things, whenever I have got problem, I used to sit in meditation. And in fact, by experience, slowly and slowly, you see, we have mastered this art of going back into the past. And therefore, you see, the trust was formed, and then institution changed. Baba changed the policy, and then we have got properties and properties. We have got more than 2,000 properties around in India and different parts of India. So this is how, you see, the trust was formed. It was registered in 16th of January, 1969. 68, Baba left body, became object on 18th January. So just 2 days before, the trust was formed. And then you see, and when Avyakta Baba came down in the body of Brahma Baba and Dadi Gulzar, he told me that that is the last gift that has been given to Brahma Kumari's family by Sakar Brahma, by Avyakta Brahma Baba to the divine family, and you develop this trust, and this will be a very useful instrument for future godly service. So this is the part up to 1969. And all those connections and relations with Brahma Baba. Now Dadi has come also, so we will have meditation. Thank you very much for your kind patience.